Hello children, once again I welcome you to my online class. Today we are going to start chapter number 2 of your supplementary reader book, Footprints Without Feet. And the title of the chapter is The Thief's Story. It's a beautiful story written by Ruskin Bond. And in this beautiful chapter, we will see how a thief is transformed by the behavior, by the kindness of another person. It's a wonderful story that produces a meaning to all of us. So let's start the line by line explanation of this chapter.
Well, children, today I am going to explain you chapter number 2 of your supplementary reader book, Footprints Without Feet, Class 10, CBSE. And the title of the chapter is The Thief's Story. It's a wonderful story written by Ruskin Bond. Before we discuss this chapter, I would like to provide you a short intro about the author, Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond, born on 19th May 1934, is an Indian author of British descent. At present, he lives in Mussoorie, and he is very well known for writing children's stories. Even the Indian Council for Child Education has recognized his role in the growth of children's literature in India. He was awarded the Sahitya Academy Award in the year 1992. He was awarded the Padma Shri in 1999 and Padma Bhushan in the year 2014. So that is a short intro about the author. Now we'll discuss this chapter in detail. I was still a thief when I met Anil, and though only 15, I was an experienced and fairly successful hand. Now, my dear children, a thief, actually not a thief, but a person who was a thief, but now he is completely a transformed man. Now he is completely changed. But when he was a thief, that time, what happened with him, how his life got changed, that is what he is narrating in this story. So wherever you'll find this I, don't get confused. This I refers to the thief. Now what he is saying, let's see. I was still a thief when I met Anil. And though only 15, I was an experienced and fairly successful hand. Now the thief is saying that when he met Anil, another character of this chapter, will know more about him in the story. So when he was 15 years old, he met Anil, and at that time, at the age of 15, he became an experienced thief and fairly successful hand. Fairly successful hand means that in most of the cases, he succeeded in stealing things. Anil was watching a wrestling match when I approached him. He was about 25, a tall, lean fellow, and looked easygoing, kind, and simple enough for my purpose. Now the thief is saying that he saw Anil when he was watching a wrestling match. So he went to him to have a talk with him, and Anil was about 25 years old, a tall and lean fellow. Lean means thin fellow. And he looked easygoing, kind and simple enough for my purpose. You know, my dear children, normally these thieves, you know, they prefer, you know, laying trap on such people who actually look very innocent or who look very simple and who can easily be trapped by themselves. So he was also a kind of that person. I hadn't had much luck of late and thought I might be able to get into the young man's confidence. Now the thief is saying that in the recent few incidents where he stole things, he was not very lucky. So this time he thought that maybe he'll be able to, you know, get into the young man's confidence. "You look a bit of a wrestler yourself," I said. "A little flattery helps in making friends." So now this thief, he wanted to make friendship with Anil, but not a genuine friendship, but a friendship where the main motto is to rob him, the main motto is to steal him. हमने क्या देखा अभी इस कहानी में कि अनिल को अपनी बातों में फंसाने की कोशिश कर रहा है ये चोर, और अनिल दिखने में बहुत इजी गोइंग, बहुत ही काइंड और बहुत ही सिंपल व्यक्ति लग रहा है, और ऐसे लोगों को बड़ी आसानी से आप अपनी जाल में फंसा सकते हो. एंड दैट इज द रीजन द थीफ डिसाइडेड टू यू नो मेक फ्रेंडशिप विद अनिल. अब अनिल से फ्रेंडशिप करनी है सो ही नीड टू यू नो स्टार्ट समथिंग फॉर द कॉन्वर्जेशन. बात करनी है, बात करने के लिए कुछ शुरू करना है. सो ही स्टार्टेड यू नो टॉकिंग इन अ वेरी डिफरेंट वे एंड ही स्टार्टेड लाइक दिस. यू लुक ए बिट ऑफ ए रेस्लर योर सेल्फ. ही इज यू नो इन फैक्ट ही इज आस्किंग हिम यू नो ही इज आस्किंग अनिल दैट यू नो यू लुक ए बिट ऑफ ए रेस्लर. अ लिटिल फ्लैटरी हेल्प्स इन मेकिंग फ्रेंड्स. फ्लैटरी हियर मीन्स प्रेज. ओके, झूठी तारीफ करना. ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड फ्लैटरी. So, you know, sometimes these type of things help in making friends. "So do you," he replied, which put me off for a moment because at that time I was rather thin. So when he said that you look a bit like a wrestler, Anil also said to this thief, "You also look like a wrestler." So the moment he said this, the thief, you know, felt a bit embarrassed. Because he was very, very thin that time. Okay? So, he felt bad. "Well," I said modestly, "I do wrestle a bit." Now, the thief is saying that, okay, well, in a very modest tone. Okay? Modest means in a very humble way. Not exactly trying to showcase yourself. You know, that is called modestly. So, in a very modest way, he said that, yeah, I also do a wrestle. I do wrestle a bit. "What is your name?" "Hari Singh," I lied. Now the thief is telling a lie. When Anil asked him about his name, he said Hari Singh. But actually, Hari Singh was not the name of the thief, but he is telling a lie. "I took a new name every month." Now the thief is saying that every month he goes for a new name. Har mahine apna naam badalta hai. "That kept him ahead of the police and my former employers." After this introduction, Anil talked about the well-oiled wrestlers who were grunting, lifting and throwing each other about. Now what the thief is saying that by changing names, by changing my name every month, what happens? It helps me to keep me away from the police as well as my former employers, means the people, you know, whom I, you know, make fool of, you know. So that is called here. Okay. Then after this, Anil started talking about these wrestlers who were grunting. You know, grunting means what? Grunting means making low, you know, a kind of, you know, sound that comes from your throat and nose at the same time. That is called grunting. So you might have seen these wrestlers, you know, wrestlers when while fighting, while, you know, lifting each other, throwing each other, they they produce, you know, some sounds that is called grunting. So that is what they were discussing about these wrestlers. I did not have much to say. Anil walked away. So after having a short conversation, what happened? Anil finally started walking away. I followed casually. And now this thief, whose name is Hari Singh is not the actual name, but I mean, in this story, he has introduced himself as Hari Singh. So Hari Singh also started following him. "Hello again," he said. I gave him my most appealing smile. So again, Anil talked to him. He said, "Hello." And this time, Hari Singh, he gave him an attractive and interesting smile. "I want to work for you," I said, "but I can't pay you." I thought that over for a minute. Perhaps I had misjudged my man. Now what happened? This thief, ye chor ne jo hai, Anil se kaha ki main aapke liye kaam karna chahta hu. Yani main aapke ghar par rehkar aapke liye kaam karna chahta hu. What did Anil said? Anil said, what did Anil say? Anil said that I can't pay you. Bhai main to tumko paisa nahi de sakta. So this thief, he thought, you know, for a minute, perhaps I had misjudged my man. Okay, perhaps I have chosen a wrong person. He's actually, you know, he's not kind of whom I can steal or whom I can, you know, rob off. He was thinking in that way. I asked, can you feed me? Can you cook? I can cook. I lied again. If you can cook, then maybe I can feed you. Now Anil again asked him, acha, can you cook? Thief said, yeah, I can cook. He said, okay, if you can cook, then no problem, I can feed you. He took me to his room over the Jumna Sweet shop and told me I could sleep on the balcony. Then finally what happened? Anil took him to his house. And where was his room? His room was over that Jumna Sweet shop. And he told him, you know, told the thief that he could sleep on the balcony. But the meal I cooked that night must have been terrible, because Anil gave it to a stray dog and told me to be off. So that night, finally, when Hari Singh, when he cooked the food, that food was very, very terrible, you know, very terrible. And Anil was not able to eat that food. So finally, what happened? He gave it to a stray dog. Stray dog means what? Jo gali ke kutte hote hain, you know, that. But I just hung around smiling in my most appealing way, and he couldn't help laughing. But still he was standing there looking at him, you know, and he was smiling. So Anil also felt, you know, bit pity upon him, and he also started laughing. Later he patted me on the head and said, never mind, he would teach me to cook. But see, Anil is a very kind person. He said, no problem, koi baat nahi, tumhe khana pakana nahi aata, to main tumhe sikhaunga. He also taught me to write my name and said he would soon teach me to write whole sentences and to add numbers. Now see what is happening here. Now Anil, what happened? Anil taught this thief how to write his name and said that very soon he would teach him how to write whole sentences and even how to add numbers. So somewhere Anil was providing, primary education to Hari Singh also. I was grateful, and for this Hari Singh was very grateful. I knew that once I could write like an educated man, there would be no limit to what I could achieve. So one thing was very clear to Hari Singh, that if I could write like an educated man, then I would easily, you know, I would easily rob anybody. And for me, stealing would become much easier. It was quite pleasant working for Anil. I made the tea in the morning and then would take my time buying the day's supplies, usually making a profit of about a rupee a day. Now what is happening? Every day in the morning, Hari Singh used to make tea for Anil, and then he would go out for buying the daily, things, the day's supplies, you know, vegetables or whatever, you know, that are normally used every day. And while buying all these things, he could easily make a profit of, you know, a rupee a day. I think he knew I made a little money this way, but he did not seem to mind. Now, Hari Singh is saying that while I was, you know, anyhow making a profit of a rupee every day, and according to him, Anil was well aware of this fact, but he never ever objected to this. Okay, तो यहाँ पे अनिल कहते हैं, हरी सिंह ये कह रहे हैं कि जब वो हर दिन सामान खरीदने के लिए बाजार जाते थे तो इधर उधर हिसाब में कहीं ना कहीं कुछ ना कुछ गड़बड़ करके एक रुपये अपने लिए बचा लेते थे, और उनको ऐसा लगता था कि अनिल को भी ये बात पता थी, यानी अनिल वॉज ऑल्सो नोइंग दिस फैक्ट, लेकिन अनिल ने कभी इस बात पर बहुत ज़्यादा गंभीरता नहीं दिखाई और इस बात को लेकर कोई किसी तरीके की कोई प्रॉब्लम उन्होंने क्रिएट नहीं की, वो जानकर भी अनजान बनते रहे. So this was all from today's video, my dear children. We'll stop here because it is quite a lengthy chapter, and we'll do this chapter in parts. So I hope you have understood whatever I have explained today, and now we'll move on to the homework section. Now these are the questions on your screens. You can see 4 questions are there. The first question: who does I refer to in this story? In the first line itself, I told you about who does I refer to. Okay, what is he? A fairly successful hand at. This is the second question. What does he get from Anil in return for his work? So that is also we have gone through. Why did Hari Singh choose Anil to be his next victim? So this is also, I think, very clear to all of you. So just go through the portion that has been taught, that has been explained to you. Find out the answers and do your homework. And in the next video, we'll continue with the explanation part. Thank you.
Well, my dear children, I hope you all have understood whatever we have discussed today in this chapter, the thief's story. I hope things are quite clear to all of you. Any confusion, you can ask me. Whatever homework has been given to you, do it. And that was all from this video. Take care and God bless you.